Welcome behind the scenes as we take you through a journey to take a normal sized person and make them look huge. Today we're taking a look behind the scenes as we take a normal sized person and give them the illusion of looking huge. Now when you guys are designing a photo shoot like this, there are a couple things you want to keep in mind. One of the big things is how are you actually going to pull off an illusion like this, and second is what you want to say through the photograph. So we're going to kind of take you behind the process, talk about the lighting, the posing, building a little bit of the set, and how we came about with actually figuring out how we were going to pull the photo off. So the original concept for the shoot was to create a metaphor for someone having a giant ego, someone who enters the room and they're the biggest personality and they want everyone to look at them. So we went about creating a person who is actually gonna completely fill a room with themselves. And that's gonna be a metaphor for their ego. So in kind of figuring out how to do that, obviously we have a, you know, not a giant person. We couldn't find one on Craigslist. So we had to get a normal sized person and figure out how to make them huge. So there are a couple things to do. First is you wanna make sure that you have your background picked out. To do this, we scouted all around Chicago and found some really nice locations and finally picked one that was gonna really work very well for creating a giant person. So you wanna make sure that you photograph or get your background plate in first. With these kind of composites, if you are gonna do a composite, what you wanna do is figure out the thing that you can't move first. In other words, that thing that, like, you know, the background, I can't really change that a whole lot, but we can change the subject quite a bit to match the background. So we start off with the background and then figure out, okay, let's try to figure out how we're gonna now match the subject to that background. And that's where kind of like building everything and the rest of the shoot comes into play. Once we decided this was gonna be a composite image, in other words, we were gonna have a photo of a background and a photo of a girl and we were gonna put those together, we needed to kind of figure out how we were gonna do this and what are some of the important things in creating a composite. Now, the most important thing when you're creating a composite is matching the lighting. So you wanna make sure the lighting in the photograph of the girl matches the lighting of the photograph in the room. So to get that, you have to make sure you first have the photograph of the room. So we went out and took the pictures of the room and figured out exactly the look and the feel, and even did a little bit of post-processing on the background so we knew exactly what the background was going to look like. Now, once we did that, we could kind of figure out, okay, now how are we going to replicate that and have an actual girl match the lighting of this giant room? To fully create the illusion that this girl was in fact in a room, we decided to build in miniature a smaller version of this room. Now, you don't have to get incredibly detailed when you do build these miniatures. The reason is the most important things are your shadows and your highlights and how the light kind of plays with your subject and the background. And you can take the subject's shadows and you can take their highlights and bring those from the image and cut the rest of, you know, the environment that you choose to build out of there. And that will help when compositing the two images together. So how do you actually build a miniature? Well, it's basically like a box. The thing we built looks a lot like a miniature torture chamber, like a dog kennel. It's not fancy at all. It's just structured with a couple 2x4s and some plywood. Now, what we did do is make sure to take measurements of the original location so we could get everything to scale. We had to measure out, you know, the width and height and the distance from the camera, ceiling height, all those sort of things. With those measurements, we then went into 3D modeling. Now, this isn't a completely necessary step, but it helps us to visualize. So in the 3D model, we were able to remodel the room and then fit a girl in there that was going to be the height of our girl, which was close to 6 foot. So we rebuilt the model of the room inside of a 3D modeling program. We put a 6 foot model in there and then we kind of bent her around to kind of fit the space. And that's how we got the scale for our final room. So without anyone in there, and it was just kind of like a test, like, I don't know how big we should make this thing. I mean, you can make it, you know, a 1:1 scale, 1:2 scale, 1:3 scale. You can make any scale you want. So doing everything in CAD allowed us to kind of figure out the scale that we wanted to make, what was going to be a cramped 6 foot girl in this room. And then we took those plans and then built the physical model from them. So we've got a lot of calculations going on. We took the big size room, we put that into CAD, we took the CAD drawings, and then we took that out to build an actual sized room. You don't really have to get this sort of thing perfect, but the most important things are the light sources. We've paid very special attention to match the light sources of the small room with the light sources of the large room. You'll notice that along the top of the image, we have kind of like these little chandeliers that are hanging, and those are what basically lighting the entire scene. We also have little lamps, like in the right side of the image, we have a lamp that's actually lighting up part of the image. Now, if you're gonna put a person in that environment, it would make sense that those would be the lights that would actually light the person. So we went through great lengths of measuring and kind of figuring out our camera angle and everything before the actual shoot. And then we drilled the holes and put our own lighting into the small box that we created. We used basically just light bulbs. We used 200 watt light bulbs and nothing incredibly fancy there. It's something that I think we built the entire box with the light bulbs and everything for less than $100. So not a huge deal in actually building the box, but having it built meant that we could basically put our model in there, snap a couple shots as long as we had our angle and everything matched for perspective, which is gonna make our job in post-production quite a bit easier. Now, oftentimes when you're doing a composite shot, you have to give your model a lot of direction because they're not actually in the scene that they're in. Let's say you're photographing someone in a studio, you're gonna make them look like they're in the middle of the Arctic. You have to say like, okay, act like you're cold. Like, what would you be doing? In this case, we didn't have to do any of that at all because we actually built a small room for this person to go in. So it wasn't like, okay, act like you're in a small room, because they actually were in a small room. We didn't have to say avoid the lights that are hanging, supposedly hanging there, because they were in fact avoiding those lights. So building this room in miniature meant that it lended the whole image to be a lot more real as far as like what the model was actually gonna be posing, and to make sure that she actually did look like she was in a small room, because we didn't have to fake that part of it. So oftentimes building a miniature, kind of building a small set like this, will really help add a little bit of like legitimacy, not only to the overall composite, but to the pose itself. So everything we've done up until now with photographing the large room, putting it in CAD, making sure we built a scale model and putting the model in the place, matching our camera angles and perspective, all of that basically sets us up for having a little bit of an easier time when we're working in post-production. So for the majority, what we had to do is cut our subject out from the background, create some really nice selections, and then tweak our lighting a little bit, and then kind of play with the feel of the overall image. So Photoshop is hard enough, trust me. What you want to do is make sure you can take all these little steps before you get into Photoshop, so when you're doing it in Photoshop, you don't have to do the unnecessary things like try to create a light source that would be behind her head, because we actually really did that. That's not the thing you want to focus in Photoshop. You want to focus in like, fine-tuning and completing an effect. So all these little steps are going to make the post-production much, much easier for you. Thanks for joining us in this journey on how to take an ego, inflate to the size of it, and fill an entire room. Look for a Photoshop tutorial coming soon. Thanks so much for watching, guys, and I'll Phlearn you later. Bye, everyone.